Hello from Greece. Election time here for the country, but also very soon for the municipalities. Mobility issues are dominant in the agenda, especially after the train tragedy in central Greece. Railway seems to be the last option for the Greek citizens, a fact that highlights the lack of safety and sustainability in transportation. At the same time, urban-rural divide becomes deeper, with a private expensive vehicle to be often the only solution for connectivity. Supporting and improving public transportation in and out of the cities shall definitely be a necessary task for the next government. If we want to talk about bikes, safe bike lanes are a priority issue for most cities, also an ambitious goal for both national and local authorities. Sustainable mobility goes hand in hand with green energy. Green e-vehicles lead to low carbon emissions, city resilience, and a step closer to climate neutrality by 2030. Of course, after overcoming some major problems, like the high cost of buying and the low number of charging points inside the road network. Not to forget about tourism in Greece, the country's so-called main industry, offering sustainable choices of transport will definitely reduce its footprint. Green ports would be a nice concept for many Greek cities and a challenge for the corresponding municipalities. Mobility poverty is out there for many, affecting everyday life and choices, and the only way to be tackled includes the participation of the citizens. Participatory design, in cooperation with local communities at neighborhood level, is maybe the answer for small-scale sustainable changes in mobility. Getting things moving is, after all, a matter of perspective and political will.